But what worries us is that when we're dead, there could be nothing at all forever. As if that was something to worry about. Before you were born, there was this same nothing at all forever, and yet you happened. And if you happen once, you can happen again. So, I reason that if I go back when I'm dead to the state where I was before I was born, couldn't I happen again? You know, what has happened once can very well happen again. If it happened once, it's extraordinary. And it's not really very much more extraordinary if it happened all over again.
have often puzzled and puzzled about what it must be like to go to sleep and never wake up, to be simply not there forever and ever. After all, one has some intimation of this by the interval that separates going to sleep from waking. When we don't have any dreams, but go to sleep, and then suddenly we're there again, and in the interim, there was nothing. And if there was never any end to that interval, if the waking up didn't happen, that's such a curious thought. And yet, you know, I believe that there, although that's rather gloomy kind of consideration, I've found that's one of the most creative thoughts I ever thought in my life. And I keep going back to it. You know, it's in line with a lot of the very fundamental questions that children ask. When they say, "Mummy, who would I have been if you had married someone else?" These are the kind of questions that make us puzzle profoundly about our existence. And one of the reasons why I think thinking about not being, about total non-existence, is so creative, is that in comparison with that thought, the fact that we are seems kind of queer, incredibly odd. But you know, in the Western world, I suppose we have two dominant ideas about what happens to us when we die.